The bulk of the fighting in Ukraine now is in the east, a region Vladimir Putin has long sought to steal. The Donbas is an industrial and mining center in Ukraine's east, as you see on the map there. And Putin is hardly the first Russian or Soviet leader, for that matter, to claim this area belongs to Russia. Let's bring in Steve Hall. He's our CNN national security analyst and a former CIA chief of Russia operations. Steve, grateful for your time. I would just want to put up, this is a 101 years old Soviet propaganda poster that shows the heart beating coming out of this region in Ukraine. It describes this area as the heart of Russia. As you know better than most, Vladimir Putin likes to fancy himself as this big, major historical figure. Why is the Donbas so important?
There's a couple reasons, John, why I think this is important, and especially for Putin. To hit on your last point first, you know, Putin sees himself really in messianic terms. You know, most people in the West, when you talk about, you know, what is a president's legacy, you know, they talk about, you know, maybe some important legislative reforms. For Vladimir Putin, he wants to be a historical figure. He wants to be the new, you know, the new czar of the next century. And part of that is reclaiming, I would argue, not so much the Soviet parts of Russia, which are still out there, but rather he wants to establish a whole new empire and sees himself as an emperor. And Ukraine has always been critically important to the Russian Empire and to the Soviet Empire, not only for the infrastructure that it provides in terms of metalworks, or coal, metalworks, and that sort of thing, but also, you know, it's the breadbasket, used to be the breadbasket of the Soviet Union. So it's important both just in economic terms as well as sort of, you know, imperial philosophical terms for Putin.
One of the questions as we've gone through this now, day 56 of the fighting in Ukraine, is will he listen to anybody? Will Putin listen to anybody except the guy in the mirror? I think I know your answer, but this is from a Russian billionaire, one of the oligarchs, Oleg Timkov, writing on Instagram, "I don't see a single beneficiary of this insane war. Innocent people and soldiers are dying. Generals waking up with a hangover have realized they have a not-so-good army," as I will paraphrase there. "The Kremlin civil servants are in shock. Not only are they against their children, don't want to go to the Mediterranean this summer, 90% of Russians are against this war." Will Putin listen? Obviously, these are the wealthy people who have benefited, who have stolen state assets and made a ton of money during his governing. But is he listening now, or is he just in the blinders?
You know, the oligarchs are in a really interesting position right now because of, you know, the fact that they became rich early on in Russia, largely with Putin's help and the Kremlin's help. So they're in a real interesting position right now economically. But in terms of who Putin is going to listen to, I mean, I think the more pressure that comes his way, you know, the better, because you just never know exactly what he's going to make his decisions on or who he is going to listen to. I think at the end of the day, there probably are some folks that are in his innermost circle, which he will listen to pieces of, not necessarily follow their counsel, but he'll listen to them. But what he will really hear is when his own interests, and that is Putinism, when his own interests are put at risk. And I think the more that becomes clear to him, and the more his inner circle begins to tell Putin, look, the stuff that you are really interested in, your legacy, your continued well-being as a leader, your continued leadership role over Russia, all of those things, as those things become into more and more question on the part of Putin and his inner circle, that those realities, I think, is what he will listen to.
But do you see any evidence it's getting through yet in the context of, you know, part of your job, part of your old job was to break through the bluster and the bravado and the propaganda and try to see, are there any shifts in his language? Are there any shifts in his actions? Today they have this ICBM test and Putin does, you know, a little chest pounding, saying that anybody who's against Russia should take deep thought here at this. That's sort of typical bravado and propaganda. Any indication this is getting to him?
So not yet, or at least I haven't seen any yet, or anything that I would indicate, signals, signs that I would indicate that this is getting through to him. There are signals that are coming out of the Kremlin. Obviously, the one that you just mentioned is clear, this nuclear saber rattling that they continue to do. So you hear some things, but it's really hard to tell what he bases his decisions on.